So Rohit will do the proceedings. Tails is the call.
It's okay.
So it's the same series. First
ball first, especially we want to finish this.
Captain Roston Chase and Rohit Kumar Powdil of final T20.
Struggled. First ball coming up of the final match of the series. It's on.
Good decent start this by young Pratish Sisi. Hey.
Wide. You call, you talk about commentator's curse. Pratish Sisi gave only two runs of the first five deliveries.
Sisi in this over so far.
And a boundary. Off the bat this time. Johnson Charles gets his first boundary. And that five wide spoiling the over for Pratish Sisi has considered 11.
Bowling with that angle, Sagar. Offered some flying this time. Kadeem trying to go after Sagar.
Somebody has taken that. I don't believe that.
Joshua Bishop and Kadeem Aline getting that opportunity.
Had to reach for it. Just went over the fielder there. So Kadeem. What a catch! Rohit Powdil. Where did that come from? One-handed. Oh, spectacular. Unbelievable catch this. Sliced the ball. Kadeem Aline going for one more boundary. One too many for him. But not this time. Has compensated to that dot delivery beautifully. This Johnson Charles has smashed one out of the park. Kind of form Johnson Charles. He's a very powerful man. Oh, he's treating Deepinder Singh Iyer with some force now. Another one that goes out of the park, was much flatter this time, and a big, big over this for the West Indies A team. Obolim, inside edge, the leg stump has gone for a walk, and Sompal Kami has sent Mark Dayal home. Beautiful delivery this. Very wide. It's gone for five wide. Realized that it was a no ball in which he got that wicket. Had to bowl. That concerns Nepal is it was a no ball. Bowls him again. The crowd excited, but was a free hit. So twice in this over, Sompal has bowled Mark Dayal, but none of them count.
Well, a bit of unlucky there, Sompal. Was a brilliant delivery to dismiss Dayal in the first. No ball that he bowled. Sagar Dakal coming back in, and yes, the Sagar's touch has once again produced the wicket for Nepal. Slower through the air, Johnson just trying to stay in the back, but just trying to play with that soft hand straight into the hands of Sagar Dakal. And this man strikes again.
And the danger man goes Johnson for 24. Yet again, quicker one, and that's straight in the hands of Rohit Powdil at mid-wicket, deep mid-wicket.
Well, Sagar Dakal, two wickets in this over. He's broken the two set men. First, the Johnson Charles, and after that, Dayal just trying to stay in the backfoot and play towards the mid-wicket region. A simplest of catch for the skipper, Rohit Kumar Powdil, and Sagar Dakal.
That's driven down to the covers for a boundary. That was a brilliant drive. It's a standing drive to the covers.
From the other end. Roston Chase once again keeping it away from Roston, but a brilliant effort out there, but won't be able to stop the ball. Offered some room to Roston Chase for just keeping ball away from his body. Just stayed back there. A brilliant hand-eye coordination.
What a player Roston Chase has been. We have seen him. That was a reverse sweep for a boundary by Roston Chase. I was saying what a wonderful player he is, and he goes for a boundary. He has been included.
Talking about T20, he stayed close toward a home, playing only in CPL. Another boundary for Roshan Chase.
That was too short by Kushal Burtel to be hit down to mid-wicket by Roshan Chase.
If you look at his numbers, you might see. And that's a wicket. A good catch there by Sandeep Jora. Roshan Chase couldn't get underneath that ball. It was overpaced all right, but it still needed to be hit. And he didn't find the middle of the bat this time. Roshan Chase is gone for 33. Nepal gets another wicket.
And Avinash Bora getting a wicket in his very first over.
Didn't get the... didn't get underneath.
Slapped this one really hard. And the umpire will again have to signal a six. It has gone all the way. It's sad of... I mean, this was a nothing delivery, really, Binod.
You give them length. And length that they hit. It's gonna be at least 80 meters. The ball did travel.
This time you'll have to say. Smashed. Another six. Slowly getting into the groove now. That's the danger of bowling Yorkers consistently, because if you're a touch short
on the right round the wicket angle to good effect, that could be another wicket. He's missed it. The fielder getting underneath it, and an easy take there for Kushal Burtel. Sompal Kami gets another one. He's been bowling really well and he's been rewarded with another wicket.
Sompal probably not happy with Rohit Bohdel. Probably he wanted an over much earlier.
Looking at somewhere around 180 minimum. That's a good shot.
Gives himself some room. Follows him, Avinash. And it will be another six.
Over.
Alec Athanas has disposed Avinash's poor delivery for a six. Another expensive over by Avinash.
He has to be below the bat all the time, and that's a good bouncer. It could be another wicket for Sompal, and it is. Sompal, whatever you have been doing, it's been paying off for you. Good bouncer, good sharp bouncer, onto an ideal height. And this time Favin Allen falls prey for a short ball. West Indies have lost their sixth. 19th over in progress, 150 batters. They were not expecting it.
Cleaned him up. Kurakesh Moti has no answer to this fiery delivery by Sompal Kami. And Sompal Kami has picked up his third. Oh, the Gulmi Express is getting a go now. Sompal Kami has been questioned a number of times for his ability to bowl. He'll bowl his final delivery. Well bowled, chased, hit in walls. They'll come back for the second run. Two runs off the final ball. 16 runs coming off the final over. Avinash Bora finishes his spell at 49 runs for one wicket after his four overs. He definitely is a rhythmic bowler. First ball. Hint of inward movement.
West Indies.
He gets the ball to seam.
Then let's see what he got for the second ball.
Punches this down the ground. Vintage Kushal Burtel. Likes playing on the rise as well. He's been out of touch since a long, long time now. That's for the second. He's going after the bowler. The connection not as proper as it was in the previous occasion, but the result is the same.
Oh, he seems in a mood today. He's not been able to cross that double digit for quite a while now, but gets going with two fours straight off the bat towards the long off region. No one there.
Board members in the background. Wonderfully done. Opened the face of the blade. Just utilized the pace of McCoy, who's really fast. And he got some bounce as well, McCoy, but the bounce was utilized by Kushal for this purpose, just to get the ball over the fielder at third.
That was a cheeky shot by
straight up, fielder underneath it, and Kushal will have to walk back again. He wanted to pull it. McCoy generates extra bounce, his pacey as well. Still no runs for Kushal. He's been dismissed for 13. Three boundaries, all right, but I'm sure he'd be really, really disappointed. The stage was set for him. Plays over the third again. Replicates exactly what Kushal Buddhil did in the third ball of this over. Just utilizing the pace of McCoy. Nepal, despite losing that wicket.
This time around, he gets the meat of the bat all the way for a maximum.
A meaty blow, isn't it? Matthew Ford was putting a lot of pressure on Asif Sheikh, but this time Asif manages to find the boundary. In fact, he's gone all the way.
Munsara sort of the day, do you reckon, Sachin?
One of the contenders for sure, Nikesh. Pick the length of the delivery really quick. The ball was not that short, mind you. 200 today. He goes after this. Into the crowd. Huge hit. Asif Sheikh has dismissed the first ball of Bishop for a massive six.
He has absolutely dispatched it for a maximum here, Asif Sheikh. Wanted to grow across in the previous over, failed it twice, but this time around just got underneath the ball and hit it a mile to the stands.
Variations they're using on this two pitches. Yet again a boundary for Anil sir. Stand and deliver, as we all know what Anil can do.
Also just offering that flight down that middle stump. It's pitched a bit full. Anil just lashing over that ball. Brilliant placement. Asif trying to create room for himself. He goes high and he goes handsome. Created that room for himself to just free his arms. Walls were just trying to come quicker through the air. He saw Asif making that room for himself, offered himself flight. That was a brilliant shot there. The bat of Asif, he got that connect.
It's high time that the other batsmen need to take up the responsibility. That was a big heave, a thick outside edge by Anil going down to the boundary on third man.
Well, Anil being lucky this time, just been tempted by the flight that Walls is offering. Just see that big heave. He goes big, he's going after this youngster. He's going after the young man, Joshua Bishop. Good cap plan from here to just target one of the West Indies A ballers. West Indies got to their 112.4 overs. Once again, oh, what a sight to see. A brilliant shot.
The stand and deliver by Asif over covers. A brilliant looking shot by Asif Sheikh, standing tall.
Off the ball. Oh, how do you describe this shot? Just utilizing the pace of the ball, playing with the field set. This is turning out to be a big over for Nepal. And with that, the 50 is up for Asif Sheikh. This is a good sign for Nepal before moving on to the T20 World Cup,
which he played in the previous edition. What a shot by Asif Sheikh way up in the sky, and that's been taken for a catch. For a moment, it seemed like that was flying all the way for six, but alas, that's a wicket of Asif Sheikh. And now it's 109 for two.
It's a shame, really. He was playing so well, Asif. Deserved a 50 today. The idea was Dutch. Built a big partnership with Asif Sheikh. These kind of deliveries will only go one way when Anil Shah is in song. And with that six, he'll get to his 50. What a time to get to his 50 for him. Anil Shah has shown a lot of maturity today. Has taken 41 balls, but did exactly what the script wanted of him.
The premium run getter of the Prime Minister's Cup. Anil Shah has done it in the international stage as well.
People across boundaries. Anil Shah goes against the turn, but he has found the middle of the bat, and this is one of the biggest hits. Oh, Anil Shah is doing it really easily now. Massive hit. Hidden walls. Treated ferociously this time by Anil. Massive slog sweep over the mid-wicket boundary. Cuts that one really hard. Oh, it looks like he'd been batting somewhere for 1 hour. Doesn't waste any time. The first ball has been cut for a boundary.
Tigers off the lease here. Deependra Singh Airy, the very first ball he faces with his great bat speed, slashes the ball, and it's
judged really well. Was not a bad delivery. Was a slow run attempted, but Kushal was ready for it. And vintage Kushal Malla smashes one over the mid-wicket reason.
That one's a biggie. Went towards the practice area. He didn't even have to look where the ball went.
An accident. Pulls. Has he got enough? No, he hasn't. Easiest of catches, Fabian Allen says. Thank you very much. Deependra Singh Airy has been disguised by Matthew Ford. Was a slow delivery. And this is an important wicket for West Indies. Deependra Singh Airy walks back. Up in the air again. I don't think he's got enough. Oh, he has. It was a miscued shot. Stayed in the air for a long, long time. Allen was getting underneath it. He was chasing the ball. Just a slow one. Has he done it enough? He'll get a boundary. He will get a boundary. Kushal Malla. Lucky runs, but Kushal will take them. Everything going Nepal's way now. Everything is going Nepal's way. 8 runs needed. Much more convincing. Straight back. 4 consecutive boundaries. And Kushal Malla is finally living up to his expectations. This is what he's known for. Cuts this one. Has he found the gap? Yes, he has. That's the victory for Nepal. Kushal Malla has scored 22 runs in this over to win it from here. This is how he ended the innings and the match and the series. Nepal have got this consolation victory. West Indies have won the series 3-2. But Nepal have come back really well. Kushal Malla.